Hello and welcome back to Excelsive. Today I have something that will help you utilize Excel for your job and in your personal life as well. Excel's Goal Seek and Solver functions. Goal Seek and Solver are powerful tools in Excel that help you find solutions to problems where you know the desired outcome but not the input. They can handle complex scenarios from financial planning to optimization and are vital for data analysis and decision making. Questions like how much votes do I need to pass a resolution, how much of a product do I have to sell to break even, or even what should be my variable cost so I remain under budget in my project can all be answered by Goal Seek and or Solver. So let's begin. Let's start with a simple scenario. And since Excel categorizes these functions under what-if analysis, let's entertain a what-if scenario. So what if you are tired of this 9-to-5 job and you want to start a business of selling office stationery? You've been working in offices for so long and you know the demand of products like paper, pen, pencils, etc. But since you are just starting, it may not be the best solution to start with many products. Let's just start with copier paper. It has a huge demand and that demand ain't going anywhere anytime soon. In every business, there are some fixed costs, such as here, rent, electricity, and some miscellaneous expenses such as cleaners, security, etc. I haven't added any employees because it's a new business and we have to keep the costs down. We have to do the sales ourselves for now. So our fixed cost comes down to $2,375 per month. Now the very first thing we should be concerned about is the break-even point. How much do we have to earn in profits every month so all of this fixed cost is covered by our profits alone? In any new business, this is a milestone. Once break-even is achieved and is stable, profits can come in. So we have this bit here. It has a cost price, selling price, and a profit which is multiplied by quantity, and our fixed cost is subtracted from it. So as of now, with zero quantity, we are down by $2,325. Which is our fixed cost. Say, if we sell 10 packets of paper, we are still in the red. What if we sell 100? Nope, still red. What if 200? Still red? You know what? This is demoralizing. Let's outsource this guesswork to Excel so we can focus on more important things, like maybe check how many savings do you have to invest in your new enterprise. So we use Goal Seek in Excel to do this calculation for us. Go to the Data tab and under What If Analysis, choose Goal Seek and you will see this box. The first option is Set Cell, which is your target cell. In our case, that's this cell here, Profit. We wanted to calculate how can we get this column to zero for starters. So let's select our cell here. To put it here, you can either click on this up arrow and then the desired cell or delete everything and then simply select the cell. The next option is to value. We want our target cell to be zero, so we put zero here. The last option is by changing cell, so we put the reference to our quantity cell here, because that is the one we want to change. We want to know how many units do we have to sell in order to get to our break-even point. Now hit OK. Here we have our result, 911.76. I know it's in decimals and it's not a plausible solution. We can't sell paper packet in parts, but let's just move past this and I'll explain this soon. So we have to sell this many units in a month in order to achieve a break-even. Doable, isn't it? By the way, did you notice we had clicked on OK and Excel has given us the result, but this dialog box didn't went away? That's because you have an option to accept this result or cancel it. So if I click on OK now, we are left with the solution provided by Excel, and if we cancel it, we get back to our original values, which was zero. Now, let's fast forward a bit. Let's say you have luck on your side and you are working hard too. Pretty soon, you have achieved your break-even point and now you want to see how much do you need to sell in order to live a comfortable life, and let's say 10 grand a month will make you comfortable. So let's fire up our Goal Seek again to see how many packets of paper do you need to sell in order to earn 10 grand in profits. Let's set sell to this, value is 10,000 and we need to change this cell. Hit OK and we have to sell 4,833.33. Still doable, right? Now, a couple of months down the line, you've been enjoying your business. But now you want to get into the big leagues. You realize now it's a perfect time to diversify your business. You have the capital to purchase some new products. So you do your research and shortlist these products here. You have been in business for long, you have stable clients, and all have expressed their desire to purchase these products from you. So you know you can get sales if you can get these products. But before we start spending money on stocking up, we need to know how much each of the product do we need to buy. Because until now, we have been dealing in only paper. And one room in your apartment, which is your temporary warehouse, is filled to the roof with paper. You can't possibly store all these items at your house anymore. That means renting some sort of a warehouse. Also, now it's time to hire some people because you can't keep track of all the sales, deliveries, accounts and whatnot. But that opens another can of worms, much more fixed cost every month. But if you want to grow, that is the necessary and the right thing to do. So let's fire up our Excel again and it's time for some more calculations. But now, we have talked to our clients, did some research of the market and shortlisted these products, and this is their estimated demand, which we have calculated by extensive research with our current and prospective clients, other dealers selling these products. So you can say that this is the potential in these products. We may not be able to sell the exact numbers, but this is the size of the market and we shall strive to get to these numbers here as closely as possible. And since you have created a strong rapport and goodwill with your clients, they are willing to give you the opportunity if you can give them the best prices and meet their demands. But you are limited to the number of units that can be stored in the warehouse, which is this number here. This is a rough estimate of a mix of items that we can store in our warehouse. For example, if we only wish to store paper clips in here, definitely we will be able to store a lot more than this in our warehouse. But if we only wish to store desk lamps in a warehouse, which have a bigger box, we may not be able to store 85,000 of them. So it's sort of an average estimate of the mix of the products. So we have everything set up, suppliers are ready, warehouse is ready. All we have to do is calculate what we need to order depending upon a warehouse capacity and most importantly, maximizing our profit. We know our profit margins per unit. This is the column where we enter the quantity that we need to order. And this is where the profit for that particular order is calculated. For example, binders have a demand of 11,275 units. And let's say we order 500 units, so we'll make 375 in profits when they're sold. Let's move to this side. This is calculation of our fixed cost. This is the bit we are already familiar with. We have been minding these costs when we were selling only paper. Now we have to consider the cost of the warehouse too. And since you haven't moved out of your apartment to live in the warehouse, we still have to pay for the fixed cost of the apartment, which have declined since all our inventory has been moved to the warehouse and most of our time in the day is now spent at the warehouse. So our electricity bills and miscellaneous expenses have come down, but the rent stays same, of course. On top of that, we have to consider these warehouse costs here. And adding all of them, we arrive to this fixed cost here, 13,705. And this total profit sell, subtract the total fixed cost from this profit here. So for example, if we sell 2,000 calculators, we earn this much profit and our total profit changes. And if we don't sell anything, our total deficit is this here. So this time we are not thinking about breaking even. We are way past that. Now we are thinking about maximizing profit. So we want to know in what combination shall we buy these products so our profit here is maximized, keeping in mind our warehouse capacity, which we can't go over, of course. Goal Seek was good with straightforward calculations. It was simple and quick, but it lacks what we call constraints, things which affect our calculation. Like in this case, we can't buy everything willy-nilly because we have limited space. So we need to place orders with maximizing our profit in mind. So we need something better than Goal Seek, which can consider these constraints as well. In comes Solver. First things first, you may have to activate Solver. It is present in Excel but not activated. If you go to your data tab and all the way to the right here, If you don't have solver, that means it is not activated. So go into File, Options, Add-ins, and at the bottom here, choose Excel Add-ins in the drop-down and click Go. Put a check mark against solver and hit OK. Now, if you go to the Data tab again, you should have solver present. Click on it and we get to this box. Don't be intimidated by the number of options, it's pretty simple. The first option, Set Objective, is the same as in Goal Seek. Which cell does it have to calculate? So we select our total profit cell here. Next is 2. Last time, we set this number to 0 to know how many units we need to sell to get to our break-even point, and then to 10,000 to see how many units do we need to sell to get 10,000 in profits. Now in Solver, we have these three options. Max, Min, and Value Off. Value Off is the same as in Goal Seek. You punch a number here and it will try to find the solutions. Like in our case, how many units of these products do we need to order to attain this number? Similarly, Max and Min are to find these combinations where we can maximize or minimize this cell. We are interested in maximizing our profit, so we select Max. Next step is by changing variable cells, which are our order quantity here, because we want Solver to find how many units of each product do we need to order. So we select our full range from here. Now we come to constraints. Take them as things Solver needs to consider while calculating our result. Like a warehouse capacity is a constraint. The order quantity should not be greater than the demand is another constraint. And as in the case of Goal Seek, when the result was in decimals, that is also a constraint. So we start by putting all of them by click on Add here, and we get to Add Constraint box. It asks for a cell reference, so we select our full range of order quantity from here, and in this drop-down select INT, which stands for integer. This will ensure that whatever Excel will suggest here in the order column will be an integer and not in decimals. Click on Add and it's ready for another one. We need to make sure that the sum of all the orders that Solver provides us should not exceed our warehouse capacity of 85,000 units. So we use this cell in cell reference. Select less than or equal to here, and in constraint, we use a storage capacity here. Click on Add again. Lastly, we want that our orders should not exceed the demand. So we create another constraint like this. This whole section in order should be less than or equal to our demand section. Click on OK and we get back to our solver window. If you want to add, delete or change any of the constraints, you can use these buttons here. We leave a check mark here where it says make unconstrained variables non-negative, because we don't want any negative values. And now check this drop down. Select solving method. This has three options and we will leave it as it is, because this method, GRG non-linear, is fast and accurate enough for our example here. Now click on solve. And if you look here at the bottom, you will see it shows trial solution and objective cell. Solver is trying different combinations to complete the job, and here it is. According to Solver, in order to maximize our profits, we can maximize our demand in all the items but this one. And we should completely skip all these items with zero order value. And if you see the total, it comes to exactly the same as our warehouse capacity of 85,000. So it has maximized the usage of our warehouse, which is a smart thing to do in order to get the most of the resources available. In this box here, if you click on OK, these values will stay, and if you click on cancel, it will revert to their original values, which was 0. We are going to accept them for now, and here in the total profit cell, L10, this is the maximum profit we can achieve considering all the constraints we gave Solver. This was one example for this video. You can check Solver with your own data set. We were working with profit, so we used the max option. You can use minimum if you're working with budgets and expenses, or maybe you want a specific value in profit, like we did in Goal Seek. In that case, you can use the value of option. It totally depends on the data available and the objectives. This brings us to the end of the video. Thank you for joining us today. I hope I was able to show you something new or interesting, or both, and that I was able to elevate your Excel game. If you have any questions or any ideas for future videos, share them in the comments. Like the video, share it with other like-minded and knowledge-hungry friends of yours. Until next time, keep learning and happy spreadsheeting.